Hi, this is Brian Pucella with Brian Pucella Freediving. Thank you for joining me today as we look at freediving masks. Some of the things we're going to look at today are the features that make a good mask for freediving. Some of the things we're going to look at is low volume. You want a mask to have a low volume. You also want to make sure that your mask is comfortable. Another thing that's popular, especially with spearfishing, is a black skirt. Some of the other things to think about is what you're going to be using the mask for. Is it going to be depth freediving specifically or spearfishing? Myself, I have a few different masks that I use for each one of these, and I'll go over and show you these and explain the differences between the two. And then finally, we'll move on to snorkels and what to look for in a good snorkel for freediving. First off, I'll just show you what I got here. This is the mask and snorkel that I use while I'm spearfishing, and if I'm training for long periods of time freediving, I tend to use this mask as well. This mask in particular is a Cressy. It has it's got these nice teardrop shaped eyes for good visibility, glass lenses. They're flat, so you get very good perception. Nothing's distorted. And this mask also is a fairly low volume mask. What we're looking here when I'm saying a low volume is the profile and the volume of air that is inside of there. What this means for us as freedivers, since we take a breath and that's what we take down with us, we need to equalize this air space that is within our mask. As we go down, the air space is compressed, and something's got to give. Usually what's going to happen is it starts to try to suck your eyes out of your face pretty much, and you'll pop blood vessels if you don't equalize that. And you can feel the suction, you know, the mask is sucking back onto your face as you dive deeper and deeper. So it is necessary for us as freedivers to equalize this airspace within here. What a low volume mask does is it takes less air to equalize this. Since we are taking everything that we have, you know, just that one breath hold of air, it is much more efficient if we can keep that air in our lungs and not in our mouth, in our mask. So a low volume mask allows us to use the least amount of air possible to continually equalize this airspace. Most freediving masks, if you're looking at the description, if you're in a scuba shop or if you're looking online, it's going to tell you if it's a low volume mask. So that's the easiest way to determine if it's a low volume mask. If you're in question, anytime that it has like side windows, that's not a low volume mask. If it just seems bigger, this profile, you know, this mask is a simple frame. This is the only rigid part of the mask, is just almost like a pair of eyeglasses. Just a simple rim going around here. The rest of it is a flexible silicone skirt. You can see I can push that all the way up against there and flatten that mask out. So it's a fairly low profile, low volume mask. That's one of the most important things to look for when looking for a freedive specific mask. The next thing you want to look at is make sure it's comfortable. They make all different size masks for different shaped faces. Nowadays, they're a bit more forgiving because just like this one, as I was showing you, it's a simple frame with this really comfortable silicone skirt. So this mask will fit a variety of faces, as will most masks with really comfortable silicone skirt. But they do make masks for if you have a really large face or wide face, this might feel a little too narrow. Or if you have a smaller face, if you're just maybe a teenager or a girls who have smaller faces, or if you just have a smaller face in general, they make masks with smaller frames, smaller skirts that might fit your face better as well. The best way to learn if the mask fits you good is to go into a shop and try them out. You know, that's the best way. A good way to test a mask is to see if it is comfortable and it's going to fit you good. So you want to make sure that it doesn't have any hard points. If you put the mask on and it hits on the bridge of your nose, or especially under here, that can be a very uncomfortable place for a mask to hit. You want to make sure it doesn't have any hard points that are hitting your face, because as you dive and it starts to suck onto your face, you will definitely feel those points. So you want to make sure that the mask fits your face and is comfortable. A good way to test that and make sure it gets a good seal is to stick the mask onto your face without the strap. So you just pull the strap back like this, stick it onto your face, press some of the air out. It shouldn't have any hard points hitting your face, and it should retain a good suction onto your face. If it pops off, or if you feel any hard spaces hitting the bridge of your nose or under your nose, you might want to try a different style mask until you find one that fits your face. Another thing that that I particularly like in a freediving mask is the black skirt. What this does is this does not allow light to enter from the back of the mask. What happens when you have light coming in through here, if this was a clear skirt, or if it had windows like a bunch of the scuba masks have, light comes in from behind, it hits the back side of these lenses and causes a lot of light diffusion and diffraction, so you have a bunch of light kind of shining back into your eyes that's being reflected off the inside of your lens. So a black skirt is very popular with photography, underwater photography, as well as spearfishing. Basically what the black skirt does is it's kind of like blinders. It makes you focus directly in front of you. You don't have any of this distracting from light or movement off the sides. Your eyes focus much better on what's directly in front of you. So the black skirt, especially for spearfishing, is really, really good. You'll be able to pick the fish out from a lot farther away, really camouflage things, or if you're filming and doing video, you'll really like the benefits of a black skirt. This is the mask that I use for, like I said, for spearfishing mostly. It has a low volume mask, but there's actually masks that are even more low volume. Another mask is by Cressy, is the Minima, and it has it's very similar to this, but its windows are even smaller. So it's an even more low profile mask, but it still retains a rigid frame, and so at some point, you know, you're not going to be able to equalize it much more. You're going to run out of air. The more modern mask that most depth free divers are using nowadays is this mask right here. It's by Aqualung. It's called the Aquasphere, and this has a completely flexible, although it's a plastic frame mask, it's flexible. The lenses are plastic and they flex, so as you go down, this mask can actually crush in and compress onto your face without it requiring so much equalization. So not only is it probably the most low profile and low volume mask on the market today, but once you reach a certain depth, you no longer need to equalize this mask, because it'll actually just continue to crush in on itself. The lenses, the frame, and everything will just kind of form into your mask, under your face, without requiring further equalization. So this is a very popular mask for depth freediving. A couple things to note about this mask, though, is with these plastic lenses, although they have a very good field of vision, they tend to distort, have a bit of distortion with these lenses. I don't use this mask for spearfishing specifically because of that problem. The first time you put this mask on underwater, you will notice that the vision out of it is not perfect. It's not really, really all that good. So things tend to bend and come around, you know, as it comes into your field of view through these curved plastic lenses. It's great for depth freediving, though, because you're not really too worried about seeing exactly perfect. It's good enough. Another thing about the plastic lenses is it takes a lot of care for these because they scratch very easy. So you have to put this back in its box after every time, or else the lenses get really scratched, or if you lay it down on a dock or on a boat or something like that, you want to make sure that you leave it face up like this. If you leave it down, you're going to scratch these lenses really easily. One of the great things about this mask, though, is this is a relatively inexpensive mask. You can usually pick this mask up for around $50. So although the lenses might scratch, it's a relatively inexpensive mask that you can replace every year or two, depending on how much you use. So that's some of the pros and cons of the Aquasphere. It's a great mask. It's what I use for all my depth diving. Also, you can see I don't have a snorkel on this mask because I don't really use a snorkel. That helps keep it more streamlined and low profile for being as streamlined as possible going through the water. So that's a look at the two masks that I use and what I use them for. This is my depth freediving mask, and this being my spearfishing mask. Now we'll take a look at the snorkel that I use. I use a very basic, extremely streamlined, simple snorkel. You can see there's no contraption up here to keep waves from coming in. There's no purge valve down here. This is a very streamlined, low profile. It's also a very flexible and soft. The mouthpiece is extremely comfortable, very soft silicone rubber, so it's very comfortable in the mask. It can bend and conform different shapes of the head, and it also is very low profile and streamlined so that going through the water you have less resistance. That's one of the main things with getting rid of the wave barriers that are up here on top, as well as a purge valve down here, is those are all major resistance when you're going through the water. Whereas a snorkel like this, much more streamlined, it's going to have a lot less effect on your ability to go through the water easy. So that's some of the things to look at with a snorkel. Making sure it's streamlined with a very simple shape. Make sure it's comfortable. Very nice soft rubber all the way through. And it's just a simple snorkel. Another thing that I'll point out is, like I said, I don't use a snorkel with the Aquasphere when I'm depth diving. And when I'm spearfishing, I try to keep everything as streamlined as possible. And to demonstrate this kind of, I tend to attach my snorkel to the back of the strap as opposed to the side of the strap. If my snorkel is here on the side, when I dive, we spit the snorkel out. If it's hanging here on the side, it tends to bang around, and it's also attached more at the middle of the snorkel. So when it's attached to the middle of the snorkel, it's like a fulcrum point and it pivots. And if it's right here on the side of my face, as you're going through the water and the water's hitting it, it tends to flap around and has a lot of resistance. Therefore, I tend to move my snorkel holder to the back of the mask. And what this does is that when I spit the snorkel, so I go for my dive and I spit the snorkel, and my snorkel comes out in a streamline with the profile of my body. It's out of the way, it's not banging around, and it's a much more efficient way for you to attach your snorkel. And you're always going to have the back crown of your head out of the water anyhow, so it keeps the tip of your snorkel out of the water just as good. So that's kind of a look at the snorkel, the mask that I use, and some of the features to look for when considering buying a mask and snorkel. So I hope that helped you out a little bit and give you a bit of a better understanding of snorkel and masks that are freedive specific. I thank you very much for joining me today. I hope it helped you out. And if you want to learn more, keep looking at brianpucella.com for upcoming events and where I'm going to be teaching. Got courses going on this fall 2012 in the Bahamas, and then I'll be back here in Pensacola, Florida. So keep checking on brianpucella.com, and I thank you very much for joining me today, and I hope this helped you out. Tell a friend, pass it along. Thanks. Have a good day.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling. Yeah, I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, I get a good feeling. Yeah, oh, sometimes I.
get a good feeling. Yeah.
WhatGodSip.com. Now I got a word for your tongue. How many Rolling Stones you want? Yeah, I got a brand new spirit speaking and it's done. Woke up on the side of the bed like I won. Talk like the wind in my chest to that sun. G5 in the U.S. to Taiwan. Now who can say that? I want to play back. Mama knew I was a needle in a haystack. Upper body boy, plus made back. I got a feeling it's a rap. ASAP.
Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling. Yeah.